Let's make this Gond art. Here I'll teach you how to mix the different elements of nature, like the bird, the fish, and the tree. Here what we did is we instead of the regular horns, we added the tree branches. So here what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a peacock, a leaf structure, and a fish. So let's start with the face of the peacock. Here I'm going to do a symmetrical design. So a curve like this. I'll just close. Yes. So that was one curve. Next, we'll do a nice curve for the body of the peacock. Extend this here. Let me give a nice beak. And a tiara. If you notice, the tiara here is the shape of the leaf. Somewhat the shape of the leaf. So that's what we'll convert that into. Next, about the wing of the peacock. That's what I made. Now I could make this as a mango shape or a leaf shape also, but here instead of that I'll just add few more strokes and you will see that the wing of the peacock will turn into a shape of a fish. So this is what Gond art is famous for. It makes sure, see, Gond was the tribe who used to be very close to nature or very close to forest, and that's the reason most of their art depicts various animals, birds, plants, and different natural forms all in one. So you see, this is how the wing of the peacock is turned into a fish. Yes, that's it. The same thing. I'll be doing it on the other side as well. Quickly give a nice round eye to the fish and a very nice eye to the peacock. Yes, so the next step, I guess, would be to paint it. Here I'm going to use chalk paints again because I wanted that matte finish and a rough texture. So I've taken a darker shade of yellow and with a simple brush I'm just painting off the head of the fish. I'll take one shade lighter of this yellow and I'll paint the rest of the body of the fish. Keeping the collar red, I won't paint that. Similarly, I'll paint the head of the peacock in a shade of, let's say, sea blue and a very mint green color to the body. Next, I've been using a fine marker, the fine liner black of Faber-Castell, and a small one, that is 0.3. So I'll just outline the tiara of the peacock. I'll make a outline to the beak as well. I'll fill up the beak completely. The tiara, using the small liner, I'll add shapes, lines inside. Next one, once it's dry, I took this watercolor and I made small orange dots inside the head of the fish. Next, again the same color. I'll fill the body of the fish, giving such two curves. Let's say next I'll change the angle and make a curve like this. One and two. Keep on changing the angles and add two curves at a time. Next is the body of the peacock. So using the same fine marker, I divided the part of the neck till the fish in such curves. I've taken a peacock green color in my brush, and keeping the brush straight vertical, I've just added small dots in alternate path that we just made. After filling the alternate path with the dots, using the same color, just filled up the rest of the paths with such parallel lines. I again took the fine marker and added few more designs by just making these small circles on both the sides of the collar of the fish and the peacock as well. On the tail of the fish, made this band again, and also added few strokes of parallel lines like this, and gave fine circle borders on both the sides. Next, with the small liner, that's 0.3. In those parts where I've made stripes, I added even more fine lines like this in between, just to make it more intricate. Of course, the step is optional. I just wanted to add in a more of design to it. Well, that's it. I did this on both the part, and the top of the envelope is ready. I'm just gonna paste this down on the envelope. At first I thought green would look good, but then I chose the blue as it was matching. So yes, I'll just paste this down, and Gond art envelope is ready. I hope you liked it. Do make something similar and share it with us. Thank you.